Will your lamps be burning bright when the bridegroom comes? So be ready, so be ready, so be ready when the bride. This is a song we used to sing many years ago. You remember those girls who were not ready when the bridegroom was coming. Boys and girls, greetings. I know you prepare for school. There are things you do before you go to school. You prepare before you go to bed. You do some things. You, when you're going to have a party, you prepare. If you're going to have a test at school, you prepare. If there are visitors who are coming, you prepare for them. If you're going to be visiting grandparents, you prepare. Or if they're going to be visiting you, you prepare for their coming. When a leader of a country is visiting a place, they prepare. They make the road look nice, the place, they put flowers and things like that. So there's preparation that takes place. And for people, when they are getting married, they prepare for their wedding day. When a mom is expecting a baby, she prepares. So there's something about preparation. If you're going to have an operation at the hospital, they prepare you for that. Well, today, there's a story about someone who was telling the children of Israel to prepare. We find that story in Luke chapter 3, verse 1 to 22, but we also find a similar story in Matthew chapter 3, verse 1 to 17, with few differences in detail. Let's listen to this story.
In the 15th year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar, Pontius Pilate being governor of Judea, and Herod being tetrarch of Galilee, and his brother Philip, tetrarch of the region of Iturea and Trachonitis, and Lysanias, tetrarch of Abilene. During the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John, the son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. And he went into all the region around the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. As it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, "The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall become straight, and the rough places shall become level ways. And all flesh shall see the salvation of God." He said, therefore, to the crowds that came out to be baptized by him, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bear fruits in keeping with repentance, and do not begin to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our father.' For I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children for Abraham. Even now the axe is laid to the root of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire." And the crowds asked him, "What then shall we do?" And he answered them, "Whoever has two tunics is to share with him who has none, and whoever has food is to do likewise." Tax collectors also came to be baptized and said to him, "Teacher, what shall we do?" And he said to them, "Collect no more than you are authorized to do." Soldiers also asked him, "And we, what shall we do?" And he said to them, "Do not extort money from anyone by threats or by false accusation, and be content with your wages." As the people were in expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John whether he might be the Christ, John answered them all, saying, "I baptize you with water, but he who is mightier than I is coming, the strap of whose sandals I am not worthy to untie. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire." His winnowing fork is in his hand, to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. So with many other exhortations, he preached good news to the people. But Herod the Tetrarch, who had been reproved by him for Herodias, his brother's wife, and for all the evil things that Herod had done, added this to them all, that he locked up John in prison. Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heavens were opened. And the Holy Spirit descended on him in bodily form, like a dove, and a voice came from heaven. You are my beloved Son. With you I am well pleased.
Now, boys and girls, in verse 10 of chapter 3, look, what should we do then, the crowd asked. John answered, anyone who has two shirts should share with the one who has none. Anyone who has food should do the same. Even tax collectors came to be baptized. Teacher, they asked, what should we do? Do not collect any more than you are required to, he told them. Then the soldiers asked him, what should we do? He replied, don't extort money and don't accuse people falsely. Be content with your pay. Boys and girls, I'm hoping that you have noticed something from the scriptures and from something I say to you. All these things, what John was doing, baptizing in water, it's something to do with the outside. It's something to do with you want to be clean. You can only be clean on the outside. If you stop cheating people like the soldiers John mentioned, it's something outside which people can see. Well, it's still important today, boys and girls, to be baptized like what John was telling people at that time. He was preparing for someone who he said he was not even fit to untie his sandals. And that person was Jesus. Boys and girls, Jesus did come. But here is the difference. John said Jesus was going to baptize with the Holy Spirit and fire. In 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7, the Bible says, but the Lord said to Samuel, do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the things people look at. People look on the outside appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. Boys and girls, the Lord Jesus did come. John prepared for him and he did come. To be ready, the people were told to do all sorts of things. So when the Messiah came, he was going to baptize people with the Holy Spirit. This is an inward thing, boys and girls, that the Lord is interested on the inside. It is good. We take a bath every morning or whatever doing. You clean the outside. There's only one person, boys and girls, who can also clean you on the inside. And that is Jesus. And that is the blood of Jesus. And the Holy Spirit comes into you. I want to say to you, that is for those who choose the other baptism, who choose not to make Jesus their friend, there is that end of being thrown into the lake of fire. John prepared for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ by getting people baptized, telling people to stop doing this and that. Jesus did come. And boys and girls, today we can be baptized in water. It's an outside showing of what is happening inside, that the Holy Spirit has come into me. I've become part of the family of God. And this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, so that no one can boast. When we make Jesus our friend, when we allow him to give us his Holy Spirit, the behaviors, the outside, things that used to hold us, cause us, create problems for us, sin against God. The more we read his word, study the Bible, things begin to change. We become more and more friends of Jesus. We begin to do those things that please him because of the work of the Spirit in our lives. So boys and girls, if you try and stop that by your own works, before you know it, you'll be back to it. I want to say to you, Jesus Christ is coming back. And how we prepare for his coming, boys and girls, is today believe what he says in his word, that he will baptize us with the Holy Spirit, choosing that Jesus, help me, I want to be your friend. Like these guys asked, so what shall we do? And he told them what to do. Maybe today you are saying, uncle, so what am I supposed to do? I'll say to you what you're supposed to do is to say, Jesus, be my friend, and he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit, and you will be his friend. Father, I want to thank you in the name of Jesus. Soap will wash on the outside. Water will wash on the outside. But we know that it's through the blood of Jesus that we can be clean on the inside. I thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit, our guider, our comforter, our protector. Thank you, Lord, for dwelling, for living in us through the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.